This is my friend Pedro. His favorite hobby is, well, eating. From tender, juicy hot dogs. To baked seafood. He enjoys them all. I guess you could say it's a pretty good hobby.
Ah, at last. I can rest.
Until it's not. Ah, look at all of those leftovers. Lucky for us, our boy Pedro is pretty responsible when it comes to cleaning up. Or is he?
Nani?
And what is up, guys? Christian Reyes here. As you may have seen, Pedro always leaves the dishes behind until someone else washes it, who knows when. And so, we wanted to give Pedro some disciplinary action. And with that, I made this. A robot that is programmed to remind you to wash the dishes, and if not followed at a given time, it turns off the home Wi-Fi. How was I able to do that? I hear you ask. I use a Raspberry Pi as an IP camera to wirelessly transmit images of our kitchen sink, which are then ingested to my computer to process the data to detect objects using You Only Look Once, or YOLO. YOLO is a state-of-the-art real-time object detection system. It is greatly optimized for fast and precise object detection model. In order to achieve this part, we will need to train our model with a number of photos of kitchenware objects. When I said number, I mean thousands of pictures. Now, with the objects translated into data, we can let the computer decide whether these objects are located in the sink. I have programmed a robot to send text messages using Twilio API as an initial reminder to clean the dishes and not leave any kitchenware in the sink. If this is not followed until the given time, the program will turn off the home Wi-Fi to forcibly make everyone at home, especially Pedro, to wash the dishes. When no kitchenware objects are in the sink, only the program will turn the Wi-Fi back on. Switching to my computer here, I went ahead in setting up Darknet, an open source neural network framework written in C and CUDA. It is fast and easy to install, and supports both CPU and GPU computations. This framework will drive our YOLO object classifier in both training and consuming our model. I'll leave the setup tutorial in the description. Next, I downloaded a number of kitchenware images, which I then used to train my custom object detection model. Link to this tool are also in the description. I used these images to train my custom model so that my robot can tell whether an object in an image is a spoon, a fork, or any kitchenware item. And for the most time-consuming step, training the model. This part took me almost 3 weeks to complete with a lot of trial and error attempts. And fast forward to a month later, I've tested my custom YOLO object detection model. And as you can see, it kinda didn't do as I expected and may need more time to train the model to have a better accuracy in object classification. But in my use case, this is good enough. This is good enough to tell whether the kitchenware items are in the sink. And now, for the moment of truth, we are going to test our robot, which has already been set up and already set up as well with the trained model, which is going to be tested with some kitchenware objects and actually sending text messages and turning off the Wi-Fi. Now, I have here a desk lamp, which will indicate our Wi-Fi status, if it's on or off. I've also hooked it up to my Wemo smart plug. And we are going to put this in this side. And now I've got some bottled water and some kitchenware objects here. And now for the moment of truth, let's run the program. Now, as you can see, it tries to turn on the Wi-Fi initially, so that whenever we run the program, it ensures that the Wi-Fi is turned on. Now, once an object is placed within the frame or within the bounding box that is in color yellow in the screen, it will turn off the Wi-Fi, and it will also send a text message in our phone. Like so, placing the object in, and if you can see, the middle isn't or like the center isn't within the bounding box yet. And if we put it in, and oh man, it turns off the Wi-Fi, the lamp, and it also sent us a text message. And it does that every 5 seconds, because that is the threshold that we set it to. So now we're gonna remove it, and it turns back the Wi-Fi on. And also, we no longer receive those text messages. And now it looks like our robot is pretty much ready to put into the battle. By the way, another router which has a limited connection to the internet is used to accommodate connections between my computer, Raspberry Pi, and Wemo smart plug so that they are not affected by the internet shutdown. And for the last piece of the puzzle is putting the Raspberry Pi in the kitchen, pointing down the sink, and setting the right coordinates in the program. Now, let's check on Pedro. Wait, what? Kitchenware detected in sink. Oh. Wait, what?
What happened to Wi-Fi? Oh man, damn you, Christian. I gotta do the dishes. There we go. How's that? Ooh, okay. Awesome.
And that is it. We hope Pedro learns his lessons from now on. Thank you for watching this video. Hit like and subscribe for more creations like this in my future videos.